After making us wait for many years, Husqvarna is finally here in India. While we were expecting it to launch the Vitpilen 401 and the Svartpilen 401, the Swedish brand had a surprise for us as it launched the Svartpilen and the Vitpilen, but in 250cc guys, and these are the two new motorcycles, the Vitpilen 250 and the Svartpilen 250. So what does these two motorcycles have on offer? Let's find out. The Svartpilen means black arrow and the Vitpilen means white arrow, and these are the two new motorcycles. Now both these 250cc bikes have made their global debut in India, and they are India specific motorcycles, unlike the 401 and the 701. The Vitpilen has a cafe racer styling and the Svartpilen is supposed to look like a scrambler, but with the alloy wheels it looks more like a roadster in our opinion. The styling of both the Huskies can be defined as minimalistic, and the clean lines make it look very modern, but the round headlight gives it a bit of retro vibe. I particularly like the floating tail section and the manner in which the LED tail light has been integrated, but the large grab rail sticks out and looks like an afterthought. Other interesting elements include body panels with few bolts, anodized finish on the engine case, neat looking exhaust muffler, and the floating tire hugger with a number plate holder. The Svartpilen features a luggage rack on the tank, something which the Cafe Racer misses out on. The Husky 250s feature a single pod LCD instrument console, and we would have liked a TFT unit. Fit and finish levels are decent, as one could see exposed wires near the headstock and the frame. Even the welds on the handlebar brace on the Svartpilen looked a bit crude. Before we get to the engine details, let us first look at the ergos of the two new motorcycles. So let's talk about the Svartpilen first. So it's a roadster style motorcycle, and the riding posture is much more comfortable than the Vitpilen. You have a flat handlebar, and even the foot pegs aren't very rear set. So you sit upright and pretty comfortable. And in terms of size, the motorcycle is quite compact. Like, I'm 5'10" and I weigh over 100 kg, so I'm a big guy. So on me, the motorcycle might look a bit small, but overall it's very compact and nice. And the Vitpilen, well, it's a cafe racer, so it has a sporty ergonomics. You get low set clip-on handlebars, and even the foot pegs are slightly more rear set and up. So in terms of the riding posture, it is, as you can see, more committed. You sit lower, and yeah, it has that sporty cafe racer vibe, which is nice. But this will be good only for your urban riding, short breakfast rides maybe. But this feels more like a city bike, while the Svartpilen is more for the highway. Powering both the Husky 250s is the same 248cc liquid-cooled single-cylinder motor producing 31 PS and 24 Nm of torque. Now this engine is the same unit as seen on the KTM 250 Duke, but there is one big difference. This motor is BS6 compliant. Now we have ridden the KTM 250 Duke and felt that engine lacked the low-end performance, and we hope Husqvarna has changed the gearing ratio or something to make it better. But this is something we shall only find out when we get to ride these bikes in February. So apart from the engine, both the motorcycles have the same underpinning, which means same frame, same suspension and same braking hardware. In fact, even the rim size is similar, but the tires are different. The Vitpilen gets more road spec tires, while the Svartpilen gets slightly off-road tires from MRF. So when can you buy these two Huskies? Well, Husqvarna has just unveiled both these motorcycles and hasn't launched them. The company says both these motorcycles will be launched in February 2020. And in terms of pricing, they claim this will carry a premium over the KTM 250 Duke. If you had to ask me, we are guessing it might be priced around 30,000 more than the KTM 250 Duke. But the exact price is something we shall find out in February. So what's your take on the Husky 250? Share your opinions in the comment section. And thank you for watching. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you like this video.